Praise the Lord. Once more, I thank the Lord for this opportunity to come before you with the Word of God. It's wonderful to share God's Word to be a blessing to you. During the past episodes, we have seen that you have been blessed and you have been contacting us on the email, through the phone, through other means. And we know Lord has blessed you, some of you. I have testimonies here of people getting healed and blessings coming in their life. It is wonderful to see that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever. So this morning, as we are in His presence, or wherever you are watching this program, I know that you're going to have a wonderful experience to know that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I was looking into the Word, and the Lord told me to speak from Luke chapter 5, beginning from verses 1. And it came to pass that as people pressed upon him to hear the Word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. And when he had left speaking, he said to Simon, "Launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught." And Simon answered, said unto him, "Master, we have toiled the whole night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down my net." And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fish, and their net broke. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in other ship, they that should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink. When Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." You see, in this scripture, in the chapter of Luke, chapter 5, verses 1 to 8, we have a deep, hidden revelation. See, Peter was a man who knew fishing. His co-workers knew how to fish. But every time they went fishing, they got some fish. But this time they came back without any fish. And they told the whole night. You see, when you are doing something for a long time and you don't get results, you get disappointed. Your idea and thinking and your approach ceases to give you an answer. As I was looking into this, I felt in my mind, it is not because there was no fish in the sea. It was not because they did not know how to fish. But it was because Jesus wanted to show them once again, He has the power not only as Lord and Savior, but as Creator over creation. You see, some circumstances in our life will come when we have no answers. Sometimes you may come into a situation where there is a problem that you cannot find a solution. This is where a believer, a faith man, has God's grace to say, "I can trust in the Lord and He will do a miracle." Many of us in our life have seen miracles. I have seen so many miracles happen in my life. Providing miraculous way of God's provision. When my children needed education, when I was without a job, or when I got a job and when I retired from my full-time work, how God has provided for me. So I know that if you trust in Jesus, definitely you have an opportunity in your life to be also tested to see if you are trustworthy. Peter and his friends told the whole night. But the moment they decided to listen to the Master's voice, see, Jesus told them, launch out into the deep, let down your nets for a draught. And Simon answering said, Master, we have toiled the whole night. See, our answers are always negative sometimes. We look through the circumstance, we go, and we think that we are knowing much better than some of the people who have experienced and told us through their life's pattern that trusting is God then better than trusting in man. So when Peter, Simon cast down his net at the Lord's word, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, so much so the net broke. See, when the Creator says something, you do it, and the creation will be in control. God's delays are not his denials. I always tell that God's delays are not his denials. Because God's word says, if you will trust in me, if you will believe in me, all things are possible to him that believeth. Here they believed his word. Even though they knew that they were made laughing stock, sometimes we are all like that. We make those mistakes and we think our mistakes are permanent. No. Your mistakes can be changed when you have God with you, when you have the Lord with you. Today I am speaking to you a special message of trusting in the Lord and relying upon his word. If he has said it and it's written in the Bible, you can believe in it. You can trust in it because his word never fails. Hebrews chapter 11 says, faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. We must hope in our life for something better to happen in our life, to something great to be done by the Lord. God has his anointing upon his people. Sometimes we forget that when he called us and he has proved us, he gave us also a promise. Anytime we can call upon him and he shall answer our prayers. God is doing wonderful things through our ministry to the nations. People call us from all over the world. People mail us. People have confidence to reach out to us through their problems. And we give them answers because of the anointing that the Lord has given us to counsel them. People of my who have touched many, many needs of ours are really a blessing, and we are a blessing to them. You can contact us on our Facebook. You can contact us on our email. You can contact us on our WhatsApp, or you can contact us through a phone call through our mobile. Why we tell you this is, people have been calling, mailing, and getting blessed. They did their part. They called us. God answered our prayers. They mailed us. We listened to what they had to say. We read what their problems are. We placed it in the throne of grace, and God has done wonderful things. Today, I see that as the boat got filled, Peter never kept what he had, but he called those around him to be a blessing too. Sometimes God blesses us financially, materially, and sometimes physically. Have you gone and helped your neighbor with your physical blessings? Have you been there sometimes when he has to shift his home to catch and lift a table or chair, or maybe to just give him a little bit of help with your physical blessing that God has given you? Your body is the temple of God. Use it for His glory. Sometimes you may have a material blessing. You know you don't need this. It may be just a small little mixie or grinder, or sometimes a toaster, or sometimes just a pot and pan that you're not using. Give it to somebody who has a need so that he will be blessed to have something that she doesn't have. And sometimes God blesses us financially. Are we ready to build churches, to build ministries, to bless people with their education, and to sponsor pastors who are in the ministry? Our ministry is mainly reaching out to the most least and the lost, the needy and wanted, with the compassion of Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel." We are doing that, reaching many of the states of India, reaching out to people who are really crying and asking, is there an answer? Yes, there is an answer. Jesus Christ is that answer. Jesus Christ is the one, the only one who said, if you will call unto me, I will answer you. Call and you shall see great wonderful things happen in your life. Today, as I was preparing to preach to you this episode, I was asking the Lord in a special way, Lord, if this could happen in Peter's life, it can happen in anyone's life. If we are ready to launch out at your word, if we are ready to pray, to believe in you, if we are ready to trust in you, I am sure God is going to bless you in a special way. When Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man. Many times when the blessings come, you know it is not because of your ability. You know because it's not because of all your education. It's not because of the quality that God has called you with. Because God does things only to people who have trust and faith. God will give you a wonderful blessing as you reach out to Him, touch Him. And Lord, I just pray, somebody here who is listening to this message will touch you today, will really put their trust in you, will really believe, my Jesus, He is the one who is going to do things. My Jesus, He is the one who is going to help me. My Jesus, He is the one who is going to lift me. My Jesus, He is the one who will heal me. Because Jesus said, you are healed by His stripes. And I pray this morning, as I'm praying here, as I'm preaching here, as I'm talking to you, you who are listening to this word, hallelujah. Let the Lord touch you in a special way. Let the Lord give you a special blessing this morning, or in this evening, or whenever time you are watching this program. God is going to do wonderful things. I am sure that in the days to come, you will be more happy to hear the blessing word of the Lord. And Lord, I just pray, it's not by my wisdom, it's not by the knowledge that I have of the word, but because of your grace. And because of your grace, if we will walk with you, you said you will teach us all things. Father, once more in the name of Jesus, I just come before you to pray for the people who are listening to this episode and this TV program. And Lord, I just pray that anointing will flow upon them. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray upon people who need blessings, Lord, especially blessings of financial needs met, of their debts to be paid. I pray, Lord, that healing will flow upon them from the sole of their feet to the crown of their head. Wherever, Lord, whichever is the Lord organ in their body that needs an healing, I just pray that this moment you will touch it, be it their kidneys or let it be their heart or let it be their lungs. I pray, Lord, like you have healed me so many times from so many diseases, you will heal them and you will touch them, Lord. Cancers, let it be, Lord, healed in the name of Jesus. Lord, blood problems, let it be healed in the name of Jesus. Lord, tumors, let it be healed in the name of Jesus. Lord, those who are bedridden and lying down and watching this program, Lord, you touch them, Lord, that their spines will be, Lord, straightened up in the name of Jesus. Father, we praise you. Once again, Lord, I pray for failing eyesight. Let it be touched and, Lord, blessed. Give them a new, Lord, vision in the name of Jesus. And I pray for our land of India. Let many more people rise up as servants of the living God to go and preach your word, not compromising, but with the power and the glory that you will place upon them. Once again, I pray for every man who has listened to this episode today. Bless him, Lord, that he will be able to tune in again and see more blessings in his life. And let him share it with others, for you are the same yesterday, today, and forever. We thank you for once more giving us grace to preach on these channels, Lord, and be a blessing. In Jesus' matchless and mighty name, amen, amen, amen.
മനോഹരം യാഹേ നിന്റെ ആലയം എന്തൊരാനന്ദം തവ പ്രാകാരങ്ങളിൽ അമനോഹരം യാഹേ നിന്റെ ആലയം എന്തൊരാനന്ദം തവ പ്രാകാരങ്ങളിൽ ദൈവമേ എന്നുള്ളം നിറയുന്നു ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടും ഞാൻ ദൈവമേ എന്നുള്ളം നിറയുന്നു ഹല്ലേലൂയ പാടും ഞാൻ ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും നല്ലവൻ തൻ മക്കൾക്കെന്നും പരിചയം ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും വല്ലവൻ തൻ മക്കൾക്കെന്നും പരിചയം നന്മയൊന്നും മുടക്കുകയില്ല നേരായി നടപ്പവർക്ക് നന്മയൊന്നും മുടക്കുകയില്ല നേരായി നടപ്പവർക്ക് പക്ഷിക്കും ചെറുകുരുകിലും ഒരു സങ്കേതം നിന്റെ യാഗപീഠങ്ങൾ ദൈവൻ പക്ഷിക്കും ചെറുകുരുകിലും രാവിലെ നിന്നൻ മകനെ ഓർത്തു പാടി സ്തുതിച്ചിരുന്നു രാവിലെ നിന്നൻ മകനെ ഓർത്തു പാടി സ്തുതിച്ചിരുന്നു ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും വല്ലവൻ തൻ മക്കൾക്കെന്നും പരിചയം ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും വല്ലവൻ തൻ മക്കൾക്കെന്നും പരിചയം നന്മയൊന്നും മുടക്കുകയില്ല നേരായി നടപ്പവർക്ക് നന്മയൊന്നും മുടക്കുകയില്ല നേരായി നടപ്പവർക്ക് ഞങ്ങൾ പാർട്ടിയിടും നിത്യം നിന്റെ ആലയെ ഞങ്ങൾ ശക്തരാം എന്നും നിന്റെ ശക്തിയാൽ ഞങ്ങൾ പാർട്ടിയിടും നിത്യം നിന്റെ ആലയെ ഞങ്ങൾ ശക്തരാം എന്നും നിന്റെ ശക്തിയാൽ കണ്ണുനീരും കഴുമരമെല്ലാം മാറ്റും അനുഗ്രഹമാ കണ്ണുനീരും കഴുമരമെല്ലാം മാറ്റും അനുഗ്രഹമാ ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാവർക്കും വല്ലവൻ തൻ മക്കൾക്കെന്നും പരിചയം ദൈവം നല്ലവൻ എല്ലാ
வல்லவர் கும்பல்லவன் தன் மக்களுக்கெங்கும் பரிச்சயம். நன்மையொன்னும் முடக்குகையில்ல நேராய் நடப்பவர்க்கு, நன்மையொன்னும் முடக்குகையில்ல நேராய் நடப்பவர்க்கு. அமரோகரம் யாகே நின்ற ஆலயம் எந்தொரானந்தம் தவ பிராகாரங்களில், அமரோகரம் யாகே நின்ற ஆலயம் எந்தொரானந்தம் தவ பிராகாரங்களில். தெய்வமே என்னுள்ளம் நிறையுந்தோ அல்லேலுய பாடும் ஞான், தெய்வமே என்னுள்ளம் நிறையுந்தோ அல்லேலுய பாடும் ஞான். தெய்வம் நல்லவன் எல்லாவற்கும் வல்லவன் தன் மக்களுக்கெங்கும் பரிச்சயா, தெய்வம் நல்லவன் எல்லாவற்கும் வல்லவன் தன் மக்களுக்கெங்கும் பரிச்சயா. நன்மையொன்னும் முடக்குகையில்ல நேராய் நடப்பவர்க்கு, நன்மையொன்னும் முடக்குகையில்ல நேராய் நடப்பவர்க்கு.
நிமித்தம் தெய்வமே நினக்கு ஸ்தோத்திரம். ദൈവനും ഈ എൻ്റെ പ്രാണനും ഇന്നെന്നും നിൻ്റേതല്ലോ. നീ തന്ന ജീവനും ഈ എൻ്റെ പ്രാണനും എന്നെന്നും നിൻ്റേതല്ലോ. നീ തന്ന എല്ലാ ദാനങ്ങൾക്കും ദൈവമേ നിനക്ക് സ്തോത്രം. നീ തന്ന എല്ലാ ദാനങ്ങൾക്കും ദൈവമേ നിനക്ക് സ്തോത്രം. പറഞ്ഞു തീരാത്ത ദാനങ്ങൾ നിമിത്തം ദൈവമേ നിനക്ക് സ്തോത്രം.